Different people tell many different stories about the past. In the Big History Project, we call them narratives. Depending upon what your evidence tells you and which elements you highlight, your narrative will change. There's no single story about past events that can tell us everything. For example, think about the last time you had an argument with a friend. Afterward, did you both agree about who was right and who was wrong? Did you both remember your fight the exact same way? Did you both bring up the same evidence to show that you were right? I'm guessing probably not. I'm guessing you both had two very different narratives about that past event. That's a small example, but in big history, we have a really big narrative about the universe and our place in it. It starts 13.8 billion years ago with the Big Bang and continues into the distant future. To support this narrative, we'll be using a lot of historical evidence, but our narrative starts long before humans even existed, so we'll often look to science for our evidence. Our course is divided into 10 units. You'll see me in an introductory video like this at the beginning of each unit. But the narrative of this course is also marked by 8 thresholds of increasing complexity, or just thresholds. I know, 10 units? 8 thresholds? What? But just think of it this way. The 10 units are like chapters in a book. They divide the big history story into blocks of time that will help us organize things. The 8 thresholds, on the other hand, are crucial turning points in the big history narrative when something really big changed. Something like the sun was born, or living things exist now. Some units have multiple thresholds and some have none. As we move through the 10 units of this course, we'll explore these 8 thresholds of increasing complexity as we try to understand how we got to where we are.